Greetings, Sky Watchers, and welcome to the sky above us. I'm James Albury, and I'm your tour guide to the night sky. A wintertime favorite is returning for your viewing pleasure, and we're almost a month away from the closest planetary pairing we've seen in almost 400 years. Wonder what I'm talking about? Let me show you. Orion the Hunter is one of the most easily identifiable constellations in the sky. Not only is he made of bright stars, but three of his stars appear to line up in a row, forming his belt. One legend has it that Orion was a great hunter, and he was such a great hunter that he boasted that he could hunt and subdue any creature on Earth. Gaia, the goddess of the Earth, was not pleased at his boasting and decided to send Scorpius the Scorpion to prove him wrong. So, while Orion was out hunting, Scorpius attacked Orion, stinging him with his poisonous stinger. The poison was so strong that it killed Orion. Artemis, the sister of Apollo, was in love with Orion, and she was so saddened by his death that she placed an image of Orion in the heavens. Gaia, not to be outdone, placed an image of Scorpius on the opposite side of the sky to mark her victory. During the course of the year, you can watch these two adversarial constellations appear to chase each other through the sky. Orion is best known as being a wintertime constellation. But did you know that depending on when you go outside, you can see Orion almost all year long? Let me show you. Okay, we have our sky set to 9:30 p.m. on November 15th, facing east. Even though we have over a month before the beginning of winter, you can catch a preview of Orion in the early evening sky. Low on the eastern horizon, you'll see the stars of Orion the Hunter. The star highest above the horizon is Bellatrix. Bellatrix marks Orion's left shoulder. Traveling southward, we see the bright star Rigel. Rigel is a blue supergiant star approximately 860 light-years away and over 10,000 times as bright as the Sun. Rigel marks Orion's left foot. Below Rigel is Safe, which marks Orion's right knee. Safe is a blue-white supergiant star almost 57,000 times as bright as the Sun. Safe is 650 light-years from us, just like the next star we're going to visit, Betelgeuse. Betelgeuse is a red supergiant nearing the end of its life. It's so large that if you were to put it in our solar system, the planets Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars would all be orbiting inside it. Back in late 2019, astronomers noticed that Betelgeuse dimmed significantly. By late February 2020, the dimming stopped and it began to brighten again. Originally, many people speculated that we were seeing the final stages of the star's life. However, further studies suggested that large grains of dust surrounding Betelgeuse are the most likely cause of the star dimming. Lastly, we have the stars making the belt. Even though these stars appear to be lined up, that's only because of our perspective. If you viewed Orion from anywhere else in the galaxy, these stars wouldn't line up at all. Starting from the star closest to the horizon and working our way upward, we have Alnitak, Alnilam, and Mintaka, which are approximately 817, 1800, and 916 light-years away, respectively. All right, let's see what the moon and planets are doing this week. Okay, we have our sky set for 6:10 p.m. on November 18th, facing southwest. You'll see a four-day-old waxing crescent moon just below both Jupiter and Saturn. On November 19th, the moon is on the other side of Jupiter and Saturn. Jupiter and Saturn will appear closer and closer to each other over the next 4 weeks, and you're going to be amazed at how close they're going to get. We'll talk more about that in our next episode. Let's advance time to November 24th and look toward the east-southeast at the same time, 6:10 p.m. The waxing gibbous moon is now southwest of the planet Mars. On November 25th, it's just below Mars, and on the 26th, it's left Mars behind. All right, my friends, head outside and check out Orion the Hunter. And if you'd like to support our program, click on the Patreon link in the description, and you could qualify for Autograph the Sky Above Us memorabilia, and you could see your name in the credits of our next episode. Orion is amazing, especially when you remember to keep looking up.